Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
There's a lot of talent here.
Yeah, I agree. There's
many, many people. Yeah, a lot of people know how to sing and dance.
Yeah, it's really good singing, actually.
Yeah. Have you heard Jeremiah sing?
I think I've heard him around.
Yeah, I've heard him sing Frozen. He's pretty good.
Oh, it's Celine Dion. My heart will go. Oh, it's so beautiful.
Makes you cry, huh? Just a little bit. Tear up.
Pretty emotional. Yeah. I agree.
Yeah.
I think he has potential in the future.
I do too.
Yeah.
Be like the next Justin Bieber.
Maybe, but maybe. Better.
But better.
I agree.
Indeed.
Mm-hmm. Let's go to this interview with Jeremiah.
So what inspired you to start singing?
Oh, I don't know. Probably 5 years old, 6.
What like artists inspired you to start? Like your favorite artists?
My favorite artist is Journey and Cory Monteith.
The wind is howling like the swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I've tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good guy you always had to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold me back anymore.
So, I'm a junior. Marco.
I'm a junior too.
You guys are all seniors.
Yeah,
class of 2015.
Do you know what colleges you guys want to go to?
Mm-hmm. Thinking like Berkeley, maybe.
Berkeley.
Palomar.
Palomar.
UCLA, maybe.
UCLA. Yeah.
Those are good.
You guys are all smart. Yeah.
Speaking of college, we actually have a video where we interview some seniors about college.
Hi, Grizzlies. I'm Evie.
I'm Raina.
And we're here with a few of your class of 2015 seniors.
I'm Trina.
I'm Cynthia.
I'm Winsley.
I'm Jarrett.
So what colleges have you guys applied to already?
I haven't applied to any colleges yet, but I plan on applying to San Diego State and a couple UCs and Cal States.
I submitted to 5 CSU so far. I've submitted to CSU San Marcos, Long Beach, San Diego, Sacramento,
Chico.
I'm just trying to stay in California.
I haven't applied to any yet, but I'm aiming toward the LA area, like UCLA and CSU Long Beach, stuff like that.
Nice, I'll see you there.
Oh, y'all are roomies together or something?
Yeah.
But I applied to culinary schools in New York, the CIA Culinary Institute of America. Nothing fancy, but.
Those are some pretty good colleges, don't you think?
Yeah.
Indeed.
Yeah. And if any seniors are confused about college stuff, they know they can always go to the counselor.
Mm-hmm. Dude, our counselor is so cool. Like, they're so welcoming. Shout out to Ms. Baker.
Our administration is pretty cool, too.
Yeah, they know a lot about stuff.
Yeah.
About the dress code, too? Yeah, well, speaking of, we actually have an interview with our admin about the dress code, so let's go to that.
Good morning, Mission. We're here with Mr. Marquette and Mr. Hanlon.
Morning, everybody.
Dress code.
All right, guys. So there's a dress code at the school. Would you guys mind explaining or how it works?
Well, I mean, I think the dress code serves for a couple of purposes. First, we want everybody to look appropriate. We want everybody to know that we're here to work and that it's not the beach, it's not the mall, it's a place where we're trying to get some work done. And then also there's some safety issues that go along with the dress code. We want to make sure that, our students aren't trying to do something that, would endanger anybody or intimidate anybody else.
Like with the hats, why can't we wear any hats?
It is a safety issue. We want to make sure that we can identify Mission Hill students. We've had numerous occasions when somebody's been on our campus and, you know, I'll turn to Robert or somebody else and we'll say, hey, why is that kid wearing a hat? And then we find out that that kid doesn't necessarily go here. And obviously we don't want anybody on this campus that doesn't belong. So it helps us identify people that may not belong on campus. And also it's, again, talking about appropriate dress and what we think young people should be wearing at a place of higher learning.
For Mr. Hanlon, how is it dealing with the dress code issue on campus?
It's tough. A lot of people don't understand why they can't wear this or that, and there's a reason for each thing. Like Mr. Marquette was talking about with the hats, it helps us out a lot. There's a reason why kids can't wear inappropriate things on the shirts. Someone would confront the kids and ask them nicely to change their clothes and take them. Sometimes they don't understand, but they always end up doing it.
Well, so would you say the dress code is more common with girls than boys?
Yes. It's mostly areas exposed, midriff exposed and that, and usually, almost always, it'll be a female campus supervisor that will approach the females, and they usually have the males approach the males.
Even though it's uncommon, what are the male dress codes?
It's kind of a bummer because we live in San Diego, but you can't wear San Diego Padres or Chargers gear, so we get a lot of that. Dodgers and anything with a drug reference on the shirts, those are pretty much the most common.
So like sports paraphernalia?
Sports paraphernalia, yeah. Padres, Dodgers, Raiders, Lakers, Chargers, any of that stuff you can't wear, which is kind of a shame. We live in San Diego County, but...
So that's why we don't get to wear hats.
Yeah, that's
makes
why.
Sense.
Understandable. Mm.
Well, looks like that's all the time we have for today. This has been Good Morning Mission.
From the library.
Yeah, from the library. See you next time.
See you next time.
There you go.
Okay.